Harry's admission before not being able to see Princess Charlotte, "What a bad uncle I am." Prince Harry described himself as bad uncle when he was not able to see his niece Princess Charlotte for a special occasion, a biography claimed. Harry is understood to have returned to California today, meaning he will be missing the Queen's 95th birthday even though it is her first birthday without her beloved husband, Prince Philip. However, the Duke of Sussex was keen to return to wife Meghan Markle, said to be about 6 months along in her second pregnancy, and his 23-month-old son Archie. The rebellious royal returned to the UK last week so he could self-isolate for 5 days before attending Philip's funeral in Windsor. It was his first trip back to Britain since his explosive exit from the royal family last March. While the estranged royal is thought to have attempted peace talks with his brother Prince William and father Prince Charles, they are said to have been unsuccessful. It is not clear how many family members he managed to see away from the televised funeral as he came out of quarantine only the morning before the ceremony. Having traveled from the US, he would have been expected to carry out another 5 days of quarantine after the funeral before socializing. His spokesman declined to discuss what Harry's plans were after the funeral, but said the royal would continue to follow the government's current COVID restrictions while in the UK. His return flight means he might not have got an opportunity to spend time with his niece, Princess Charlotte, and his nephews, Princes George and Louis, despite not seeing them in more than a year. Biographer Angela Levin explained in her biography Harry, Conversations with the Prince that this is not the first time he has missed a significant chance to see his niece. The Duke of Sussex also skipped Charlotte's christening back in 2015. Ms. Levin said, Harry missed Charlotte's christening, which was held on July 5 at St. Mary Magdalene Church at the Queen's Sandringham Estate, as this time he was in Africa. He felt rather guilty. Speaking to the manager of Save the Rhino in Africa, Simpson Urey Cobb, he reportedly said, What a bad uncle I am. He added, I should really be there, but today I am here, this is where I want to be. Ms. Levin continued, he explained that it was a recce trip on behalf of William II, and he'd be taking a lot of new information back home with me for my brother and me to analyze, and we're going to work out a strategy for doing more in Africa and to encourage new conservation. He said, It was something really precious to me and I'm learning a lot. Harry's quick return back to the US means he will be missing his brother and sister-in-law's 10th wedding anniversary, as well as Prince Louis' 3rd birthday this Friday. But, he may attempt to send a gift overseas for his nephew, especially as Harry has previously splashed out on presents for the 2-year-old. He reportedly intended to spend £24,000 on Lewis Carroll's Through the Looking Glass, but reconsidered it when thinking about Louis H. He still ended up paying a staggering £8,000 for a first edition of A.A. Milne's Winnie the Pooh book for Louis' christening. Harry and Meghan sent gifts to George, Charlotte and Louis for Christmas, too, despite the ongoing fallout between their families. Equally, the Cambridges are unlikely to meet the Sussex's new daughter, who is set to arrive this summer, anytime soon, especially if the brotherly rift continues. Some critics predict that Charlotte or Louis may follow in their uncle's footsteps and boycott royal tradition, as neither are direct heirs to the throne. This means they are likely to occupy the same difficult position as Harry did as the spare, without a clear path or position within the monarchy. The Cambridge children have actually pushed Harry further down the line of succession, although in a 2017 interview with the Mail on Sunday he said this did not bother him at all. He said, The reason I am now 5th, in the line of succession, is because of my nephew and niece and I could never wish them away. They are the most amazing things ever. Equally, the Cambridges are unlikely to meet the Sussex's new daughter, who is set to arrive this summer, anytime soon, especially if the brotherly rift continues. Some critics predict that Charlotte or Louis may follow in their uncle's footsteps and boycott royal tradition, as neither are direct heirs to the throne. This means they are likely to occupy the same difficult position as Harry did as the spare, without a clear path or position within the monarchy. The Cambridge children have actually pushed Harry further down the line of succession, although in a 2017 interview with the Mail on Sunday he said this did not bother him at all. He said, "The reason I am now fifth in the line of succession is because of my nephew and niece, and I could never wish them away. They are the most amazing things ever."